Samsung Galaxy A72 review. But before we start, please support us by pressing the like and subscribe buttons, so that we can continue to provide the latest information about gadgets and technology. Also, turn on the bell button to get the latest updates. Your support means a lot to us. Thank you. Samsung's Galaxy A family has been a major success for the Korean giant in recent years. In fact, it now represents the largest portion of the company's sales. That's no coincidence either. There is only one way to pull off that level of success, and it's by offering competitive features under high-profile branding for a reasonable amount. A daunting task that Samsung has been tackling like a true smartphone champ in nifty incremental steps throughout the last few Galaxy A generations. The A family seems to constantly be growing as well. The lineup is sprawling, with new models seemingly popping up every few weeks. There is so much choice now, ranging from budget to nearly flagship-grade models, that Samsung could have easily spun it off into a sub-brand of its own. Not that we are suggesting they should. As of writing this review, the Galaxy A72 represents the highest-end model in the family. It is actually quite similar to the Galaxy A52, we recently reviewed. The vanilla version, that is, not the 5G one. Compared to the A52, the A72 offers a slightly bigger 6.7-inch, 90Hz display, an extra 8MP telephoto camera and a slightly bigger 5000mAh battery. Other than that, the vanilla A52 and the A72 are pretty much identical, including physically rocking a particular modern Samsung design. Samsung Galaxy A72 specs at a glance. Body, 165.0x77.4x8. 4mm, 203 grams, glass front, plastic back, IP67 dust/water resistant, up to 1 meter for 30 minutes. Display, 6.70 inches Super AMOLED, 90Hz, 800 nits, 1080 by 2400px resolution, 20:9 aspect ratio, 394p. Chipset, Qualcomm SM7125 Snapdragon 720G, 8nm, octa-core, 2x2. 3GHz Creo 465 Gold and 6x1. 8GHz Creo 465 Silver, Adreno 618. Memory, 128GB 6GB RAM, 128GB 8GB RAM, 256GB 8GB RAM. MicroSDXC, uses shared SIM slot. OS/software, Android 11, One UI 3.1. Rear camera, wide, main, 64MP, f/1.8, 26mm, 11.7x, 0.8 micrometers, TAF, WAH, telephoto, 8MP, f/2.4, 1.0 micrometers, TAF, WAH, 3x optical zoom, ultra wide angle, 12MP, f/2.2, 123 degree, 1.12 micrometers, macro, 5MP, f/2.4. Front camera, 32MP, f/2.2, 26mm, wide, 1.8, 0.8 micrometers. Video capture, rear camera, 4K at 30fps, 1080p at 30/60fps, gyro ice, front camera, 4K at 30fps, 1080p at 30fps. Battery, 5000mAh, fast charging 25 watts. Miscellaneous, fingerprint reader, under display, optical, 3.5 mm jack. At the time of writing, the A52 starts at €350 for a 4GB/128GB unit, while the A72 costs €450 for its base 6GB/128GB tier. So the upgrades in the higher tier model will set you back around €100 on top of the A52. Arguably, not quite as competitive on the value scale, but not bad either. Especially with features like the IP67 rating under its belt. Also, actual retail prices on both models have already come down a bit since their release, and the price difference should eventually shrink even further. Samsung is all too familiar with the kind of stiff mid-ranger competition it is facing in the space. One more thing worth noting is that currently, there is no 5G variant of the A72 on offer. It is likely in the works, though, and has already been popping up in leaks. We can probably expect it to offer a 120Hz display, like the 5G variant of the A52 does. Potentially with a chipset swap from the Snapdragon 720G to the 750G 5G as well. That would make for yet another exciting model in the Galaxy A family. For now, however, we have a regular Galaxy A72 in for review in awesome blue, with 6GB of RAM and 128GB of expandable storage. Let's dive in. Unboxing. The Samsung Galaxy A72 ships in a fairly plain two-piece box. Nothing too fancy, no plastic, just paper. Thick and rigid, it gets the job done. You don't get much in the way of accessories either, just a wall charger and a few leaflets, and that's about it. That being said, unlike the Galaxy A52, which ships with a simple 15W charger, the A72 comes with a proper 25W PD1, including a white USB Type-C to Type-C cable. This is great news since the phone can, in fact, charge at up to 25W, and you don't need to go out and buy a compatible charger to make use of the higher speed charging with the A72 like with the A52. Depending on how you look at this, a proper charger in the box can be deducted from the total price of owning the A72, or rather added to the potential math of getting the A52 instead and have you adjust the value calculation a bit. The new design language, spearheaded by the Galaxy A52 and A72, looks very trendy, clearly targeted to the young Gen Z crowd, mainly with a creative and social angle. The new design mainly focuses on the rear panel, which now features a soft and silky finish, almost like a vinyl skin. The actual feel is sort of smooth and rubbery but also slightly silky. It is particular, and we recommend trying it out for yourself before committing since the reactions around the office to it were varied. It is available in Awesome Black, Awesome White, Awesome Violet, and Awesome Blue. Awesome is sort of a marketing cornerstone for the A32, A52 and A72, with Samsung really hammering in the model's awesome battery, display and camera and the Awesome is for everyone slogan. Back to the eye-catching back, though, we honestly can't take our eyes off of the A72. The Awesome Violet we got on the A52 review unit already had that effect on us, but the Awesome Blue, as seen on the A72, is somehow even better. The soft pastel tone just works. In fact, it is nothing short of awesome. Another peculiar element of the back design is the slightly more pronounced lip, for lack of a better term. The plastic back on the A72 slopes down at a more aggressive angle and sort of tucks into the phone's middle frame. Samsung also did the outline of the camera island slightly differently, basically smoothing it out and blending it with the back panel. Despite this, it is clearly inspired by the original design language of the Galaxy A51, with some inspiration for the accents also being drawn from the Galaxy Note 20 family. The bill of materials on the A72 is nothing special. Both the back and the middle frame are made from plastic. Even so, it feels very well put together and solid in hand. Compared to the previous gen Galaxy A71, the A72 has grown in pretty much every dimension. Measuring 165x77.4x8.4mm, it tips the scale at 203 grams, which is also a noticeable uptick. However, both the extra thickness and heft are put to good use with increased battery capacity from 4500mAh to 5000mAh. One thing that really stands out on the Galaxy A72 is the IP67 ingress protection rating. This is a first for the Galaxy A family and is very much appreciated. Controls. It is great to see a 3.5mm audio jack here. It is positioned on the bottom frame, and unlike on the Galaxy A52, does not require strategically boosting thickness on the middle frame around it. The A72 is thick enough to accommodate it a bit better.
Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe to watch more videos like this.